Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Can you share your screen or should I share the screen for you? Roughly, are you still there? He's suddenly gone. Karafi, are you still there? I guess he is disconnected. So why don't we okay, Karafi is joining in again. Evelyn, would you please? Evelyn, where are you, Evelyn? Okay, Evelyn, would you please tell us about you and share your experiences about learning English? What's wrong, Karafli?
Okay. I would like to restart the introduction again because I accidentally left the meeting. So, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good afternoon, and my name is Muhammad Safri Raihandi. I am currently studying English literature at Mula Warman University. As you can see on my status. I was born in Samarinda on February the 5th, 2002, and I'll give you the education background of myself. So I started my elementary school on SD Negeri 007, currently named as SD 002. Next up, I enter MTS Negeri Model in 2014 through 2017, and I have joined Creative English in 2015 through 2016. Lastly, I joined SMA Negeri 3 Samarinda as my high school alma mater. I joined in 2017 and graduated in 2020 and currently studying in Universitas Mula Warman or Mula Warman University. So, here are my hobbies, the people I look up to, and some of my favorite notable people, mainly artists and sportsmen. And here I also provide you the contacts in case you want to make friends or mutualan. So you can contact me in this section.
Okay. So you have so many social media.
Yes.
Okay. Which one is more popular?
I frequently use WhatsApp and Instagram, but Instagram is more often.
Okay, we talk more about your experiences later, especially in English learning.
Oh, you can see what I have done okay. During my creative English years here. So on the last set, I joined the spelling bee competition held by UPT Bahasa, and then coincidentally 4 years later, I am studying in the same in the same department, and you've got good old Evelyn right there.
Yeah, hey. This is kind of Evelyn.
This is Evelyn and this is me.
Evelyn is here today.
You still remember the picture?
Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And next up, I've joined also the same field of competition, the Spelling Bee 2 in English for Spelling Bee competition held on 30th of October 2016 in Swiss Bell Hotel.
This one, the right side.
Yes, Evelyn is in the right side, and I'm the second from the left.
Get no file. Okay, next.
And lastly, I joined the Quick and Smart competition in SMA Negeri 10 Samarinda, held on December 2016. I actually participated in both occasions. The first occasion was in January 2016, and then the second occasion was on December 2016. And lastly, before I took my examination, I took my last shot on a competition called English Master in Bunga Bangsa, and alhamdulillah I won the first place, which is quite surprising because on the past competition I didn't win at all. So what a surprise to close my school, my middle school journey.
Yeah, the point is that you never stop trying and you got the precious result in the end. Do you have any next slide?
Yes. That's all the slides, sir.
Oh, that's all the slides. Okay, you don't actually put anything on your English competition during high school.
Yeah, because it's on the different situation or different era. So I think I should only include the moments during my middle school. Oh yeah, I also took English speech during the graduation ceremony. Do you still remember that, sir?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, I was the only man who took keynote speaker as an in English because two of the remaining speaker were female, one in Indonesian and one in Arabic.
Okay, so you gave a speech in English?
Yes.
Yeah. Great. Thank you for the introduction, Karafli. Okay. Do you want to share again something or
what? I think that's enough.
Okay, that's enough. Okay, maybe we turn to Ka Eflin. He is there already.
Hold a minute.
Okay, Kathleen, it's time for you to introduce and tell us about you a little bit, especially during your high school, your junior high school years in MTS Negeri.
Okay, sir. Is it okay if I don't use your screen?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
I already assigned you as a co-host.
So, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
So guys, good afternoon. My name is Muhammad Eflin Rizkullah Limbong, and currently I am studying in MAN 2 Samarinda. That is right beside your school. Right now I am 17 years old, and I am an alumni of MTS Negeri Samarinda, just like Karakli. So in my past days, I went to primary school in Indonesia, which is SD Negeri Satu. And then after that, I moved to Australia, which is another country, Australia, and I studied there for 6 years. And then I came back and went to primary school again for 1 year, which is the sixth year in Madinah boarding school, Madinah primary school. And after that, for my junior high school, I went to MTS Negeri Samarinda, and there I joined English club in my first year, seventh year, until the ninth year. Then after I graduated from MTS Negeri Samarinda, I went to Mandua, and that is where I am right now. I haven't went to college yet.
So you're still 17 years old.
Yes.
And you are now studying at MAN 2 Samarinda.
Yes.
12th grade.
Yep.
Okay. During the past 3 years in MTS Negeri Samarinda, can you share your achievements, especially in English competitions?
In junior high school, sir.
Yeah, in junior high school.
Junior?
Junior high school during your study at MTS Negeri Samarinda.
In MTS, I've joined English club just like I said before, and I have attended many competitions just like Karakli did, and I mostly did competitions, the same competitions as Karakli did, which is in Bunga Bangsa, the Leaf Festival. I attended it for 3 years straight. So when I was grade 7, I attended LEAP, grade 8, and grade 9, and I won all of them as the first winner and one second winner. Is that right, sir?
I cannot remember well.
I think the first winner, all of them, so three times. And then at UPT Bahasa, the one that cut off me joined as well, the Balai Bahasa one, I won duo storytelling as the first winner for three times, for 3 years, with my friend, which is, his name is Habibi Fauzan, he's my best friend, we've been working together, and yeah, and many more competitions.
Including the one in SMA 10, Samarinda.
That was kind of a...
But you won, right?
Yeah.
The third place, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay. Speech. How about the debate?
The debate, I think that was in the seventh grade. It was a team debate. Yeah, and we won first place in Lee Mua Bangsa.
Congratulations. Yeah. Yes, that was good.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Kak Evelyn. Before we move on, do you have any questions for Kak Rafli or Kak Evelyn? Go ahead, open your mic and your camera. You can ask any question regarding English learning or anything related to competitions. Just raise your hand and open your mic and your video. Okay, Rafi Amazaka, do you want to ask something? Hello, Rafi Ahmad Zaka.
Yeah, Pak.
Do you have a question or any questions for both of them?
No.
No? Okay. Who wants to ask questions? Please go ahead. No need to be shy. Silahkan yang mau nanya. You simply raise your hands and then you open your microphone and your camera and then you speak. Silahkan ya, ada. Ya, silahkan. Ada yang ditanyakan? Ya, saya ulangi ya, Karaf ke Evelyn ini SD-nya 1 tahun di Indonesia, kemudian pindah ke Australia. 6 tahun ya, Kak Evelyn. SD-nya di Australia.
Yep.
Ya, kembali lagi ke Indonesia, SD lagi karena belum selesai. Lalu setelah itu baru ke MTs negeri. Ada yang ditanyakan? Silakan. Jangan malu-malu. Oke, bahasa Indonesia juga bisa, silakan. Sepertinya masih malu-malu ini. Ya, silakan Kak Rafli. Kak Rafli mau nanya apa nih? Mau nanya siapa ya?
Mau nanya Evelyn deh. Because okay. It is my first time to hear that Evelyn was actually took a school in Australia. Like,
bedanya
apa?
What the?
You didn't know about that?
You didn't know?
I think I knew about 3 or 4 years ago, but I would like to ask you questions. Like, okay, is there any difference though between learning culture in Australia and Indonesia?
Oh, there is a very significant difference, I would say.
Tolong di-spill dong, Kak. Kami mau tahu loh.
Hey, apa bedanya pendidikan di Indonesia sama di Australia?
I don't have to explain because mostly everything is better there.
Okay. Maybe you can limit the scope. What you said, it's pretty better, you know, better than what we have here in Indonesia. Yeah. In what aspect?
Well, facilities. Mm-hmm. I think that's more better there, and the learning techniques, I think, and also how the teachers explain to you about the materials. So yeah, I have a better understanding there, and I mostly grew up in that country. So when I came back here, I kind of had a hard time adjusting to the culture because for me, I think it is easier to study in Australia because they really support the children there. They help. They really help them to learn. So in Australia, mereka tuh pakai digital board, bukan whiteboard. Jadi dari
komputer,
proyektor, nah layar. Kita spidol ya, pakai apa? Pensil buat layar gitu. Terus mostly it is the environment there, the learning environment there is kind of the same here, but it's more what do you call it? More laid out nicely.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And also the people there, they have different kinds of behaviors in here. I mean, like as kebiasaan culture, kebiasaan
habit.
Yeah, habits. I think like okay. In here is big difference between mm-hmm. behaviors of people.
It's
kind of hard to
explain. So in short, everything is better there.
Yeah. For me. Yeah.
Okay. Did you experience any culture shock when you first came to Australia?
Of course. Jelas, sangat.
What was it? Just one example, please.
Ya pertama sih perbedaan lingkungan kan kayak orang beda. And also saya pas pertama kesini saya nggak tahu bahasa Indonesia sama sekali. So I only knew English when I first went to Indonesia, came back, and for I think 3 weeks I learned Indonesia myself at home, and then I went to high school.
Yeah, jadi kesananya culture shock, baliknya juga culture shock.
Yeah.
Double culture shock. So, do you have anything to say to the students right here about maybe to motivate them to study English?
Well, kalau kalian mau keluar negeri ya belajar bahasa Inggris.
Why? Tell us why.
Because right now, as in our time, I think English is a must-have language to learn because mostly the world uses English to communicate with others. And in here, it's the second language.
No, I think it's a foreign language still. Foreign language.
Oh yeah, but something you have to learn.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Di sini masih anggap bahasa asing, jadi kalau kita ngomong bahasa Inggris saja sedikit mungkin dikira pembualan atau apa. That's
yeah.
Hal yang perlu di mungkin tidak usah dipikirin. If you want to go to move forward, ya ngomong aja, nggak usah takut, nggak usah apa. Di sini nggak ada ngejudge, silahkan. Mungkin Kak Rafli, bagaimana Kak Rafli? Any ideas?
Motivation? Oh, yes, to quote Rick Astley, never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down. So
tapi crawling gitu.
Yeah, I mean like don't give up and don't let yourself down, just like Rick Astley has said to us.
Who's that?
Serial Love Officer, murid Mr. pas anu itu, pas di kelas 92 itu.
But what is his name?
Serial Love
Officer.
Hi, sir. Can we have it?
Oh yeah, I remember him. So, intinya adalah kalau ada mimpi atau apapun yang diinginkan, harap di jangan putus asa untuk terus menggapainya. Dan salah satunya adalah menguasai bahasa Inggris. Karena apa, Kak Rafi, kira-kira alasannya? Why do you think we need to study English?
Because you can't deny it. English is everywhere these days.
Mm-hmm. Everything.
Rasanya tuh kalau misalnya kamu nggak bisa bahasa Inggris tuh pasti ada yang kurang kalau sekarang. Kalau dulu mungkin bisa dibilang ya bahasa Inggris itu kayak supplemental lah. Bahasa Inggris, ya, supplementary. Jadi nggak begitu diperhatikan. Tapi sekarang kalau saya lihat-lihat, apalagi selama beberapa tahun terakhir, kayaknya hampir semua anak muda itu pasti berpapasan dengan bahasa Inggris. Bahkan beberapa istilah bahasa gaul yang digunakan anak muda pun juga ada yang pakai bahasa Inggris loh.
Apalagi sekarang zamannya online, jadi apapun
ya
ada bahasa Inggrisnya.
That one too. Ya.
Oke, yang lain teman-teman ini yang masih kelas 7 ada pertanyaan nggak? Silahkan. Kalau tidak ada kita ke materi. Monggo. Ini nih, Wangsa Wastu tertawa so hard. Kenapa dia tertawa? Recall, what's recall? Oke, ada pertanyaan? Mungkin dari yang perempuan, yang cewek? Ayo, ojo isin-isin. Boleh tentang pelajaran bahasa Inggris, boleh tentang bahasa Inggris secara umum, silahkan. If you cannot speak English, you can use Indonesian, atau mau mix Indonesian English juga boleh. We are here not to judge your English. Ayo, kalau nggak mau mulai dari sekarang, nanti malu-malu terus sampai...
Ya, yeah, speaking about malu-malu, I think I still remember when I first joined competition in 2015.
Yeah.
And I regret, saya sedikit nyesel ya, kenapa sih harus malu-malu pas ketika tampil. Padahal itu udah kesempatan emas di mana bisa nunjukin diri sendiri, tapi disia-siakan begitu saja. Jadi kalau misalnya kalau malu-malu terus kapan bisanya gitu loh. Makanya konsepnya never give up. Apa jangan-jangan perlu kasih recall lagi nih biar makin semangat.
Stop. Oke, sepertinya tidak ada yang bertanya karena mungkin masih malu-malu. Kita ke materi dulu ya. Oke, minggu lalu kita membahas tentang kegiatan selama pandemi. Jadi fokusnya adalah penggunaan present simple. Materi sudah saya share di grup WA. Sudah dibaca belum? Ini yang kelas 7 sudah dibaca belum materinya? Halo? Halo?
Sudah.
Alhamdulillah ada suara. Ya. Ini saya ulangi saja ya, sedikit saja. Mungkin sudah pelajari katanya tadi. Ya, untuk simple present atau simple present tense, kita biasanya gunakan to be atau action verbs. Tergantung ya, kalau to be kemarin, biasanya untuk menjelaskan kata sifat, kata keterangan waktu, dan kata benda. Misalkan, it is a book. Sebentar ada yang masuk. Dan seterusnya. Kemudian ada yang menggunakan action verb. Can you see the screen? Bisa kelihatan screen-nya?
Iya. Yes, sir.
Action verbs digunakan untuk menjelaskan apa yang dilakukan seseorang atau telah dilakukan biasanya bersifat fisik atau mental. Nah, sekarang fokusnya ke present simple. Present simple digunakan untuk mendeskripsikan habits, kebiasaan, unchanging situations, situasi yang tidak berubah, general truths, kebenaran umum, dan fixed arrangements, aturan yang sudah fix. Nah, untuk contohnya seperti ini, untuk subject he, she, and it, the verbs needs to be added with an S or ES. Kata kerjanya harus diikuti S atau ES. Atau ES nih, IES. Yang ditambahi S nih mostly almost every verb. Biasanya kalau ditambahi S ini hampir semua verb, tapi yang ditambahkan ES, itu biasanya kata kerja yang berakhiran apa? SH. Seperti wash. Jadi kalau orang ketiga tunggal, he, she, dan it, kata kerjanya tambah s. Selain wash, ada yang tahu nggak selain kata wash, kata kerja apa lagi yang ditambah es? Ayo. Ada yang tahu? Kemarin sudah di-share materinya. Kata kerja yang berakhir apa, Kak Rafli? Yang biasanya tambah ES. Ada yang tahu? Biasanya kata kerja yang ditambahi ES selain berakhiran wash seperti wash tadi, saya juga kata contoh lainnya smash, apalagi
watch
yang berakhiran CH ya. Jadi kata kerja berakhiran CH, kemudian SH, kemudian X.
Apalagi? Oh ya, fix fixes berarti.
O.
Dalam rumah.
SS. Tendok tuh dia. Jesus. Tadi. Watch.
Masuk zona.
Patch.
Easy boy. Gila, memang tanpa
kawan. Akhirnya SH. Contohnya?
Brush.
Okay, brush. Wash. Mesh. X.
Box. Fix. Box.
Easy boy.
Wax. Okay, smash. That's right. Wong Su. That's right. Wong Sa. Smash, okay. Terus apa lagi berakhiran O? Oh, kalau fox itu bukan kata kerja ya. Fox itu kata benda. Terus apa lagi berakhiran O? Go, do. Berakhiran S? SS?
His. H-I-S-S. His. Hissing, hissing. His. Okay.
His itu suara apa? Nah, suara ular ya. His, has, miss. Nah, ini adalah contoh kata-kata kerja yang di untuk subjek he, she, it ditambah dengan s. Ini sudah hancur ini. Kemudian yang ditambah dengan s, yes. Yang yes gimana? Yang berakhiran es nih. IES, kata kerjanya yang berakhiran apa seperti apa? Ada yang tahu? Halo. Panji mungkin? Panji tersenyum. Oke, benar ya, berakhiran nih ada nih yang sudah jawab. Wah, Wangsa. Mungkin Wangsa bisa langsung ngomong nih. Wangsa, can you please open your microphone, please?
Yes, sir.
Ya, coba sebutkan kata kerja yang ditambahkan IES. By the way, are you okay now?
Yes, sir.
Sudah sembuh?
Sudah, Pak.
Alhamdulillah. Oke, contohnya gimana? Yang berakhiran apa?
Christ.
Ya, kata kerja yang berakhiran konsonan. Kemudian huruf
S, eyes.
Ya.
Oh.
Contohnya apa nih kan T R Y. Ini huruf apa? Konsonan. Dan huruf akhirnya adalah Y. Ini konsonannya. Baru Y, makanya ditambahkan jadi T R I. She tries. Oke, sana. Selain try, apalagi Wangsa?
Price, Pak. Price.
Price nasi.
Ini Pak sudah.
But.
Gimana?
Menangis ya, cry. Ini yeah. Sama nih, cry.
Cry.
Price. Terus? Study.
studies.
My sister studies. Nah, ini huruf konsonan tambah y. She studies. Beda sama yang kalau di sini vokal baru y ya, misalkan play. Play apa play?
Plays.
Pakai yes atau tidak?
Tidak, sir.
Kenapa? Di sini karena apa? Karena ini huruf O. Huruf vokal. Kalau ini kan huruf konsonan. Konsonan. Makanya dia tambah S. Kalau ini karena nggak ada konsonannya, langsung aja. Plays. My brother plays. Selain
Pak,
play?
Sebenarnya nge-lag, Pak.
Ini nge-lag ya? Selain play?
Iya,
Pak. Gak apa-apa. Selain play? Pray. Apa lagi? Selain dua ini apa? Ini fly ya. Fly di sana. Fly. Pray. Stay. Masih nge-lag?
Masih, Pak.
Masih. Kalau ini masih?
Masih rada-rada nge-lag, Pak.
Masih. Masih? Can you see the screen now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Nah, yang tadi itu he, untuk he, she, dan it saja ya, dalam kalimat positif. Kalau dia kalimat negatif, dan pertanyaan, dia kembali ke bentuk semula tanpa penambahan s atau s. Cuma ada kata kerja bantu does. Misalnya, she doesn't, he doesn't, does she, does he, dan sebagainya. Kalau bentuk pertanyaan dan negatif. Sekarang ini, untuk subject they, we, you, I, atau are you, they, we, biasanya kalau di sini ya, tidak mengubah kata kerja sama sekali. Jadi they cash, they buy, they write. Tidak ada ditambah s atau es atau es tadi. Untuk Dewi UI. Kecuali Ayu Dewi tadi ya. Contoh. She runs in the park. Ini orang ketiga tunggal. Maka kata kerjanya adalah runs. Tambah dengan s. Dan the lion jumps. Nah, ini tadi yang salah satunya pakai fly. Karena dia benda atau hewan, it kata gantinya, maka kata gantinya ini it, maka kata kerjanya tambah yes, karena berakhiran fly, berakhiran konsonan plus y tadi. Ini tidak ada perubahan karena kata kerja, kata karena subjeknya adalah they, drinks, Sarah, karena tambah S di sini karena dia orang ketiga tunggal. Kata ganti Sarah apa? He, she, apa it?
She.
She.
Okay. Ini she sleeps. Sally play. Ini sama karena Sally orang ketiga tunggal. Kata gantinya Sally apa? Nah, Sarah bingung. Sally kata gantinya apa? He, she, it?
She.
She, good, Panji. Throws. Nah. So, ada pertanyaan? Ini kan masih bentuk positif semua ini. Do you have any questions? Ada yang ditanyakan? Silahkan kalau ada yang ditanyakan. Kak Evelyn sama Kak Rafi boleh menambahkan kalau ada yang kurang?
Oh, I think it's clear enough, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Ya, yang lain ayo. Kalau ada yang tanyakan, monggo. Nanti bingung. Kalau dalam kalimat positif, Ayu Dewi kata kerjanya tidak diubah. Tapi untuk kata kalau subjek he, she, it tadi kata kerjanya ditambah apa? S atau BTS. Tergantung konteksnya ya. Sekarang kalau dibuat negatif bagaimana?
Kalau pakai Ayu Dewi berarti do not verb-nya. Contoh, I do not play basketball.
Okay.
You do not sleeping. You do not sleep tonight. They do not drink milk. He does not sleeping.
Oh. Why don't you sleep at night?
Yeah. Because he is watching football.
Ya, kalau dalam kalimat positif tidak diperlukan kata kerja bantu. Tapi kalau dalam kalimat negatif dan pertanyaan diperlukan kata kerja bantu. Kalau untuk subjek he share, kata kerja bantunya apa?
Us.
Yes. Kalau untuk Ayu Dewi kata kerja bantunya apa?
Do.
Do. Ada yang ditanyakan? Jangan diam-diam baik, tapi nanti ditanya bingung. Monggo. Panji, ada pertanyaan tidak?
Nope.
Nope. Atika, Safa, Umardi? Do you have any question?
No, I don't have any questions.
Is it clear enough? Yes, clear enough.
Yes.
Ini ya, yang mungkin belum ada yang kurang paham, ini saya ulang lagi sebelum kita latihan yang lain. Ini ya, kalimat positif, he tries. Kalau untuk negatif, kita perlu kata kerja bantu, does. Kata kerja bantu ya, bukan kata kerja. Kata kerjanya yang try di sini. He doesn't try, dia tidak mencoba. Does he try? Apakah dia mencoba? What does he do? Apa yang dilakukan? He tries. Untuk positif, he, she tadi ditambah nih, s atau es atau es tergantung dari kata kerjanya tadi yang sudah disebutkan. Terus untuk kalimat negatif dan pertanyaan, ini negatif dan notnya pertanyaan, ini yang pertanyaan yes no question, ini yang pertanyaan WS question. Ada kata kerja bantu does untuk he, she dan it. Untuk I tidak ada penambahan tes. Ayu Dewi tadi, I, you, they, we. Tidak ada penambahan untuk kata kerjanya. Untuk kata kerja bantunya adalah do. Untuk negatif dan pertanyaan, do, do. Seperti, what do you know? What does he know? Nah, itu tergantung dari subjeknya. Ada pertanyaan? Tidak ada? Kalau tidak ada, kita coba game sebentar. Sebentar. Bisa lihat chat box-nya enggak sekarang? Sudah lihat? Can you see the link? Bisa dilihat sekarang?
Iya, Pak.
Oke, coba. Nah, coba masuk dulu ya. Sudah masuk? Bisa masuk? Bisa. Kak Raffi juga boleh, silakan. Kak Evelyn. Silakan dicoba, silakan. Jangan masuk di ini webnya masing-masing ya. Ini contohnya saya tidak menjawab. Silakan. Ya, silakan. Sudah masuk? Sudah masuk belum? Wei, uang saya. Nah, ini baru Wangsa nih, selesai nih. Mohaban Muhammad Nabihan. Yo, yang lain? Sudah.
Saya nomor 3, Ustaz.
Wah, congratulations. Mana nih hasilnya nih? Lihat kelihatan bentar ya. Ya, ini hasilnya Kak Rafi di pertama. Kemudian Itab Malik di kedua dengan nilai, wah nilainya kok jauh sekali nih, 399. Rois keempat, kemudian Alka Givari di urutan kelima, 6 Fauzan, Nabila Fatimatu Zahra, Atika Syafa di posisi ke-8. Wangsa keturun ya ke posisi 121. Susah apa mudah?
Agak susah.
Susah ya. Kita lihat ya. I wasn't here yesterday. Kemarin. Susah. Kemarin saya tidak di sini, tapi sekarang saya di sini. Jadi jawabannya apa? Jawabannya apa? Kira-kira. Ayo, kira-kira jawabannya apa? Masih kan ada pertanyaan tadi. Apa ya? Kira-kira jawabannya apa?
I'm.
Saya apa?
M. M. Pertama.
Skripsinya masuk kedua ya. Dia biasanya titik-titik bahasa Inggris sebelum tidur. Dia. Jadi kata
kunci.
Studies. Nah, tadi udah dipelajari. Studies.
Studies.
Okay. apakah Pak Tono mengajar matematika setiap hari Senin? Kata kerja
yes.
bantunya.
Yes. Yes.
Karena Pak Tono adalah he ya, jadi pakai does. Pat. Tom dan saya berlatih bahasa Inggris. Berlatih. Kata ganti Tom dan saya. Yang mana?
E.
Ya E. Kata gantinya mereka. Eh kami. Jadi kami nggak pakai penambahan S. Kakak saya biasanya mandi jam 6, sebelum jam 6 sama pandemi. Ya sebelum pandemi sekarang dia mandinya. Dia pakai yang mana? Pakai S ya, T. Untuk I, she tadi tambah dengan S. Ibu saya tidak membantu saya. Yang mana?
Doesn't help.
Pakai S apa enggak?
Enggak.
Ya enggak, karena sudah das, jadi dia kembali ke bentuk awal, enggak pakai S ya, ke bentuk awalnya. Saya enggak bisa buat kue yang enak 2 tahun lalu, tapi sekarang saya bisa. Sekarang bisa. Bisa apa bisa? Dapat?
Can.
Apa B?
I can.
B.
Can.
B.
Mama suruh apa 2 kali percobaan.
Dia selalu datang lebih awal. Yang mana? Dia.
Tom.
Oke, siapa Anda?
Oke, mungkin
dia tadi he she pakai apa?
Tom.
Itu biasanya sarapan dengan nasi dan tahu goreng. Has apa has?
Has.
Has.
Has. Habis.
Okay, one last question. Apakah wanita yang selalu mengirimkan paket itu ibumu? Apakah wanita? Ayo yang mana?
It.
Apa?
Is.
Yes.
Tolong dijelasin dong, Sir, yang nomor 10.
10.
Iya. Kan ada yang enggak tahu tuh, kan awalnya kan mereka cuma tahu pakai do sama does. Kok yang terakhir kok pakai is? Tolong dijelaskan, Sir.
Kayaknya bisa jelasin enggak kenapa jawabannya is? Are you still here, Kaiflit?
Soalnya
tuh, yeah, blank. The woman who keeps sending you packages, your mom. Coba kita hilangkan who keeps sending you packages. Dihilangin. Apa jadinya?
The woman keep.
The woman.
Say sending me.
The woman.
Kata kerjanya kan keeps.
Ini deh ya. Lihat kan? Coba kita hilangkan ini ya. Ini kan wanita yang mengirimkan kamu parcel itu ibumu. Kalau kita hilangkan di sini. Kira-kira apakah itu ibumu? Oke, apa di depan ini?
Oh,
apakah itu kamu? Gimana? Apakah itu kamu?
Is.
Is. Is that you? Is that your mom? Is the woman your mom? Nah, yang tadi itu hanya relative clause ya. Ini penambahan info saja untuk mengacu. Apakah wanita yang, ini seperti bahasa Indonesia juga, yang mengirimkan paket itu ibumu? Jadi, kalimat utamanya kan bisa ini, woman, bisa dibelah dua, dipisah jadi dua. Ini saja, jadi harusnya pakai is di sini. Is the woman your mom? Is the man your dad? Nah, ini info relative clause untuk menambahkan. Jadi kalau dibagi kalimat ini bisa jadikan dua kalimat. The woman is your mom. The woman keeps sending you packages. Hey. Nah, kembali ke materi tadi, salah satu penggunaan dari present simple adalah untuk menggunakan atau menjelaskan kegiatan sehari-hari. Minggu lalu sudah saya berikan tugas kegiatan sehari-hari. Mari kita lihat ada beberapa yang sudah mengirimkan. Ini siapa sih ini yang mau kita lihat ini? Kira lihat ini siapa ini? Kita lihat punya lagihan ya? Enggak. Is the screen clear to see? Kelihatan screen-nya?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, I think it takes too long. Let's choose another one. Okay, can you see the? Okay, this is the result from Aulia Nur Fauzia, class 95. My routine is during the pandemic, I wake up. Nah, kata kerja wake up at pray.
Usually excuse me, sir, the picture is still not there. It's still stuck on the option menu.
Really?
Yes.
Wait. How about now? Sekarang gimana?
Yep. All clear.
Okay, this is the one made by Raffi Hamazaka from class 7-2. My activity during the pandemic is a little bit different. I wake up and pray subuh at 5 a.m. I help my mother to wash. Nah, ini ya, kata kerjanya. Saya bold saja, saya kasih highlight. Clean the house. I take a bath. I always have. Nah, ini karena subjeknya I, jadi kata kerjanya tidak berubah. Seandainya kalau jadi she di sini atau he atau my mother, gimana? My mother wake up atau
wake up.
Okay. Terus pray-nya gimana?
Praise.
Helps.
Okay.
Clean.
Yes.
Take.
Helps.
Helps. Now I do not go to school. Jadi gimana? She, kata ganti-ganti tadi, does apa do?
Does.
She does not go to school. She only, Elka, she only apa? Ini ada kata study tadi. She only.
Studies.
My teachers-nya banyak apa satu?
Banyak.
Banyak. Jadi kata gantinya adalah they. Kalau they pakai teaches apa teach? Yang mana?
Teach.
Teach. That's right. Jadi nggak pakai s karena kata ganti mereka teachers berlatih. Paham ya? Okay. This is one of the example. Sekarang ngomong langsung deh. Dari tadi Bapak ngomong. Nabila mungkin bisa ceritakan kegiatan sehari-hari selama pandemi. In English, simple, yang simple-simple aja. Nabila Fatima Tuzahro, kelas 7-10. Monggo. Nabila, dibuka aja mikrofonnya if you want to tell us the story of your daily routine during the pandemic.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
So, my name is Nabila Fatimatus Zahro. You can call me Nabila. And I want to tell you about my story during the pandemic. So, I wake up in...
at 5:30 jam 5 5 o'clock 5 a.m. atau 5 a.m. terus
and
after that, what do you do? Do you pray? Do you perform subuh prayer? Hello. Lupa. Oke, okay, kita coba ke Akar dulu lah. Nabila mungkin masih mikir-mikir dulu. Oke, okay, Rafi Ahmad Zaka, silakan. What do you do every day during the pandemic? Rafi.
Study at home.
Study at home. Terus?
Help my mother.
Help your mother. And then? What time do you take a bus?
At
6 o'clock. Okay. How long do you study at home every day?
5 hours.
5 hours. Is there something different before and during the pandemic?
Yes.
What is it? Bedanya yang apanya?
I don't go to school.
I don't go to school. Do you have any new hobbies during the pandemic?
Yes.
Can you tell us what your hobby is?
Drawing.
Drawing.
Yes.
Jadi sebelum pandemi itu lu nggak suka drawing?
Nggak tahu sih.
Oke, okay, thank you, Raffi Ahmad Zaka. Ini kita minta contoh dulu ya dari Kak Evelyn. Kak Evelyn, are you there? Are you listening?
Yes.
Okay. Can you tell us what you do during this pandemic?
My schedule.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Where are you? I cannot see your video.
I was doing something.
Okay.
So, I wake up at 4:45 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What was it?
I go to the bathroom.
Can you speak louder?
Okay, and then after that, I pray.
Mm-hmm.
I go to the mosque and I go home.
Mm-hmm.
It depends on the weather. And after that, because of the pandemic, usually go to sleep.
Go to sleep after subuh prayer.
Yep.
Okay.
Because there's no school at 7. You sleep until 7:30. And then at 7:30, I prepare myself for school, online school. And then at 8 until
12.
Till 10.
10?
Till 10, I study via online. Then at 10, I have my breakfast.
I have?
Short break.
Okay. Short break, and then?
After that, I continue my study till 12. And that is the end of my online.
So the you study starting from 8 to 12 o'clock.
Yeah.
That's practically you what you do every day.
As in, so?
That's what you do every day mostly.
Well, I do homework.
Okay. Can you tell us the significant difference before COVID-19, before study online and during the pandemic right now? Well, what is the difference?
Morning sleep.
Yeah. What do you mean? You cannot sleep.
In pandemic, I
sleep a lot.
And mostly sleep after school prayer. When we are going to go offline, like via go to school, I never go to sleep because. Well,
so you have to prepare yourself to go to school, but because it's because it is online, you have time to sleep after Subu prayer. So that's this.
Big difference there is we are very late when it comes to online school.
Because you slept. You oversleep?
No, not oversleep. I mean, don't really have that much motivation.
Oh my god.
How but about I still.
Okay, how about at night? Do you sleep late?
Yeah, mostly doing homework.
I mean, because you play games like most kids right now.
Well, behind the fact.
Do you develop new hobbies? Ada beberapa yang mungkin karena pandemi ada yang punya hobi baru. Ada yang suka masak, ada yang suka bikin video-video, TikTok, atau yang lain. How about you?
Me, personally, I like to exercise. So,
so you go to the gym?
I go to the gym. Yeah. I do heavy weight exercises and running also in treadmill and sometimes outside.
I see.
Yeah.
Before the pandemic, you don't do that. You did not do that.
No.
As often as right now. Okay. Thank you, Kak Evelyn. Kak Rafli, how about you?
Pardon me, sir. So, okay. I wake up at 5:30. And do the subuh prayer just like you guys do, and I continue. I always sleep when there is no class after subuh prayer, or when there is class. There are classes available during the morning session. I usually sleep after the class ends, and then I do the prayer and have some. Some lunch or breakfast.
You have classes after after zuhur.
Yeah, technically so. I rarely eat during the pandemic.
Same question for you. Do you have new hobbies right now?
I learn languages on Duolingo during my COVID vacation. I learn.
What do you mean vacation? It's not vacation. What's wrong with the lights? Are you in the club or something?
Maybe you can see.
Oh my
just
god.
Just friends doing friends things. Pardon me, sir.
Okay, it's okay. Thank you, Karafli. So your new hobby is practicing Duolingo.
Languages.
Hopefully you can speak like Fikinaki or something?
Okay,
thank you, Tarafli.
Tarafli, I have a question for you.
Okay, what is the question?
Kak, hello.
Yo.
Have you ever been threatened by Duolingo before?
Have you ever been trapped?
Threatened by Duolingo before.
Train or trap?
Diancam, diancam.
Threatened.
I get it. Yeah. Sering banget diancam. Apalagi kalau udah apa namanya? Udah lagi enggak kepengen push rank, tiba-tiba muncul notif, "Hi, it's Duo here. Kamu enggak belajar bahasa ini selama sekian hari loh."
Ah.
Ready to die.
Is it a game?
Yeah, it's practically a game.
I thought it was like, you know, learning a language application or something.
Yes, it's language learning application, but it's like a game.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. Okay, ini yang lain, ayo kita undang buat ngomong nih, masa kakaknya aja yang ngomong. Kita pilih ya. Yang dipilih harus ngomong kegiatan sehari-harinya. Atau Kak Raffi memilih nih? Mau yang cowok atau yang cewek? Tunggu. Atau yang mau duluan silakan. Ayo ngomong, nanti gak bisa-bisa ngomong. Kak Raffi mungkin mau pilih kemana? Yang mau ngomong silakan angkat tangannya. Atau you can write anything in the chat so we will know who you are. Gak ada yang berani ngomong. Kevin mau pilih salah satu enggak?
Okay.
Please, you know, select one of the participants that are present today. Jangan-jangan ada yang kabur ini, takut dipilih.
The one who's gonna talk, don't be shy, guys, because we are learning right now, and it's okay to be wrong.
Nah, tadi kakaknya bilang jangan malu, kita lagi belajar, jadi kalau salah nggak usah takut ya. Yang mana, Kak Evelyn? Henry, Adlia Al-Hakim, Fauzan B. Azad, atau Mahia Maiza? Muhammad Faturois. Come on, Faturois, please unmute yourself and show us your face.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Wih, very handsome.
Wih, kalah Kak Evelyn.
No.
So, can you tell us what you do every day during this online learning?
My activities in the middle of a pandemic, I usually wake up at 5 a.m. My school starts at 8 a.m.
Are you sure? 7:30. Okay.
My school starts at 5 o'clock. I always eat breakfast
in school. So you always eat breakfast before the school begins. And then?
I always eat breakfast.
Enggak pakai S ya. I always eat breakfast. Eat
breakfast before school.
Okay, terus?
After school, then I take a shower.
Take a shower. What time is it?
Sebelum salat zuhur.
So you do not take a bath before school?
No.
Ketahuan. And then after zuhur, what do?
I'm I help my mother.
You help your mother. Very good. And then at night?
Yeah.
At night? In the evening? Di malam harinya ngapain?
Sleep.
What time do you sleep?
9.
At 9.
Yes.
Oh, you don't play games like most children right now? Most kids, you know, play games right now? Enggak.
No. I'm
jangan bohong.
What's up?
What's up? What do you mean, what's up? Ya, bagus ya. Saya kalau lihat status-status teman-teman kalian ini, kalau nggak TikTok, game statusnya. Alhamdulillah, Fatur Royce tidak, bukan salah satunya ya. Thank you, Muhammad Fatur Royce, Moko Robin.
Karena anyway, sir. Pilih satu. Can I appoint someone?
Yeah, sure, one.
Yeah, probably I would like to invite the one who use period username. Yang pakai namanya titik-titik itu, please come and present your daily activity.
Yang pakai titik satu ini ya?
Yes.
Oke, nggak tahu nih siapa ini. Ya, yang merasa titik satu namanya, silakan show your face. Open your microphone.
I maybe don't know you, but I think I know what are your intentions. So, in order to make your intentions come true, so I will invite you to this forum to discuss about your daily activity during pandemic.
Ojo negative thinking. Ya, ini yang namanya titik saja. Silakan. Sepertinya dia tidak menunjukkan perubahan.
Okay, I'll move to the other person.
you didn't succeed.
So, is there anyone who shares the same name with me yang namanya sama-sama Rafli? Mohon raise your hand.
Rafli 79, silakan. Rafli 79. Mana nih Rafli 79 tadi? Saya ada lihat namanya. Rafli 79, are you still here?
Atau jangan-jangan dia lagi yang pakai titik?
No, different one I think. Tidak ada nih.
No?
Sepertinya sudah.
Di Trafi Ahmad.
Trafi Ahmad.
Trafi Ahmad I think.
Trafi Ahmad itu di Jakarta kayaknya.
I see.
Trafi Ahmad. Are you sure his name is Trafi Ahmad? I don't see any name. Rafi Ahmad sudah tadi, Rafi Ahmad.
Oh, deh. Berarti Wangsa udah belum?
Wangsa belum
Wangsa?
Tadi.
Did you hear me?
Wangsa,
do you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, Wangsa.
Ah, good. So, please tell us about your daily activity during pandemic.
Okay. I'm waking in
7 a.m. I'm waking. Okay. I wake up
in 7 a.m. and
are you opening
to take a shower in 7 jam setengah 8 apa Pak Pak?
Half past 7
apa Pak?
Half past 7
I start to opening my handphone and search all the group about the my homework
lesson. And, yeah. You don't take a bath?
Yes, I'm take a bath.
You take a bath. What time?
7 past.
It's okay. Jam 7 pas atau apa nih?
Jam 7 Jam setengah 7, Pak.
Jam 7, half past 6. Jadi jam 6 lewat 30. Half itu kan 30, separoh. Half past 6.
Yeah.
Kalau mau yang lebih simple, 6:30.
6:30, okay.
Terus, what time do you study?
At 8 p.m.
8 p.m. until?
Until 9 p.m.
Huh?
1 hour. One hour study.
1 hour? Tiap hari satu jam doang? Seriously? Enggak sampai jam 12.
Tapi terkadang.
Enggak sampai jam 12?
Enggak, Pak.
Oh my God, are you sure about that?
Yes.
Baru tahu nih. Oke, ada yang berubah nggak dari kegiatan sebelum dan sesudah atau selama pandemi? Is there any change?
Ada sih.
You spend much more time gaming?
Mostly, yes.
Okay, kita box sih. Is there a new hobby?
My hobby is running.
Nggak, sebelum pandemi misalkan mungkin nggak ada hobi tertentu, tapi karena pandemi ini banyak waktu jadi ada hobi baru. Ada?
Yeah.
What is it?
Running.
Running. Running away from problems?
No, not like that.
So why? What are you running from?
From my house to.
Okay, this is you. No, I mean,
play with other friends.
Okay, thank you, Wangsa.
Playing football, yes. Okay. Yes, sir.
Kita coba yang perempuan deh. Belum ada nih perempuan nih. Ada Safira, ada Atika.
I think I will go to
Atika coba. Atika.
Iya, Atika sama. Coba.
Atika ini keren ngomongnya nih.
I like the virtual background.
Ya, ada hijau-hijau. Oke, Atika, yes. Please. Share.
Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Atika.
Yes.
Who made the screen for you? The background is very beautiful. Did you make it yourself?
Nope. Okay. I just found it on Pinterest.
Ah, I see. And then you make it as a background.
Yes.
Okay. So in 1 minute, can you tell us what you do every day?
Wait a minute. So my routine,
yes,
during the pandemic. Actually, sebelum pandemi itu bangunnya I usually work at 5.
Mm-hmm.
But this pandemic, I work at 6.
Ah, why? Why do you wake up late?
I don't know.
Do you play games at night and sleep late?
I don't play games.
And then
I do the subuh prayer, and then I do some stretching, make my bed, then take a shower.
Mm-hmm. Do you take a shower before or after school? Online school, I mean.
Yes.
Do you take a bath before or after school?
Before, of course. Before.
So it hasn't changed. Nggak berubah. Yeah. Okay. Is there any significant change between pre-COVID and during COVID right now?
I think ada.
Yeah. What is it?
Because I think I became a unproductive person.
Really?
Why
don't you try new hobbies?
Because I spend more time
watching,
on my bed.
Sleeping, watching, eating?
No.
Browsing the social media, watching YouTube?
Yes. Scrolling through the social media.
Okay.
Scrolling through the Twitter timeline or like TikTok, Instagram.
TikTok. Do you make TikTok videos as well?
No.
No. You said that you are unproductive, right?
Yes.
Why don't you make, or why don't you like a new hobby or do a new hobby?
I think I also found some new hobbies, such as reading books, and also writing books.
Reading or writing?
Both.
What is writing?
Both. Reading and writing.
Reading and writing. That's good. You said that it's a productive, very productive skills. Hasilnya ada?
Yes.
Do you have any, you said your writing is productive skill, right? So what is the result of your writing?
Gimana ya? Menulis tuh kayaknya belum berani publish. Selalu kalau nulis ntar taruhnya di draft aja, nggak ditulis, nggak dipublish gitu.
Short story apa poems gitu atau apa?
Yes.
Cerita pendek atau puisi atau
gimana ya?
Novel?
Yes.
Ah.
Fan fiction.
Okay. Why don't you try to send your writing to the publishing company? Who knows? You'll become very popular one day.
I mean.
Okay, thank you, Atika Shefa, for sharing.
Yeah, thank you. You're welcome.
Okay, yang saya harap di minggu depan lebih banyak lagi yang ngomong ya. Dari tadi dikasih kesempatan banyak diem, banyak enggak nanya, enggak ada. Dikasih kesempatan untuk berbicara tidak malu-malu. So I hope next week I can see more of you speaking. Okay.
Okay, sir.
It's almost the end of our meeting. Once again, thank you so much for your presence today in this Zoom meeting, and thank you, Kak Rafli, both Kak Rafli and Kak Evelyn.
No problem,
for
sir.
For being in this Zoom meeting. I hope we can meet again one day. I hope you won't be bored joining again.
Yes.
Okay, thank you for once again for all of you. Keep your health. Don't get sick. That is all for today. Thank you so much for your attention. See you again next week. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, don't forget to fill in the attendance list, okay?
Nah, selesai.
Sudah sembuhkan Wangsa? Saya N ya.
Yes.
Okay.